I think the singularity is the most likely non-catastrophic event for the near future. So that doesn't mean that it's certain. It doesn't mean that terrible things might happen instead. But I think any time you're contemplating something that can replace the most competitively effective feature that humans have, its intelligence, that it's entirely natural that there would be some real uneasiness about this. The nearest analogy in the history of the Earth is the rise of humans within the animal kingdom. It is very unsettling to realize that we may be entering an era where questions like, what is the meaning of life, are practical engineering questions. And there's no doubt that that should be very unsettling. On the other hand, I think it might be kind of healthy if we sit down and look at the things we really want and look at what they would mean if we could get them. Humans are better characterized not as the tool-creating animal, but as maybe the only animal that has figured out how to outsource its cognition, how to spread its cognitive abilities into the outside world. We've only been doing that for a little while, like 10,000 years. Reading and writing is outsourcing of memory. If you notice more and more substitution of fragments of human cognition into the outside world, if the human responsibility, occupational responsibility, becomes more and more focused on areas of judgment that haven't yet been automated, then what you're seeing is rather like a rising tide of this cognitive outsourcing.